Hello, I'm Mr. Armiger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm doing exposition of Luke 16, verse 14 onward. So, the law and the kingdom of God, it should be the royal kingdom of God, because our kingdom is not under law, but under grace. The secular kingdoms are under law, and they seek local currency. Our currency is gospel currency, which is universal. The Pharisees, who were lovers of money, here you are, they loved money, so they did whatever they liked, you know, heard all these things, and they ridiculed him as the hireling, dog-collared priest ridicule me, that they are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. When I tell them you are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing, dipping your hand into the church purse, which people have donated, and there's no difference between you and Judas Iscariot, they get angry with me. The laborer is worth his keep. But that was added, you know, by these Messianic Jews as corruption. Christ Paul, he never take money from the church. He gave to the church, did not take anything out of the church. He was working as a tent maker. That is called devotion. But these people are not devoted. They are working like a secular job. At 65, they want to retire and leave the people unattended, sheep to the wolves. So, in Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing, they retort that they need money to live. And I quote that a laborer is worthy of his labor, is of gospel treasures and not Mammon treasures. No Christ Paul, he gave to the church and did not take anything out of the church purse. And he said to them, you are those who justify yourself before men. That is what they do, you know, before men. And the other person will say, oh, he needs money for living in the house, to electricity, this bill and that bill. But he loves Mammon. But God knows your hearts. Just as these church priests do, they are working for Mammon, and they say to the other, they are working for God. They are hypocrites, you know. For what is exalted among men is an abomination in the sight of God. So, we don't seek the praises of people, but the praises of our Father. The law and the prophets were until John. There is a clear, you know, the law and the prophets were until John. It's a very beautiful saying, because law, because we are under spirit, is gone. Prophets, because we ourselves are Christ. When you are a Christ, you don't need any guidance. You don't need any prophet. So Jesus came, he introduced to us our Father, and that was his job, and made us independent, solitary, royal priest. Royal priests don't need a prophet. Only the priest need a prophet. So the law and the prophets were until John the Baptist, you know. Since then, the good news of the royal kingdom of God is preached, and everyone forces his way into it. So everyone want to go into the royal kingdom of God, but only by the grace of our Father that you enter. But it is easier for heaven and earth to pass away than for one dot of the law to become void. Now this one, you know, they have corruption added, these Jewish people. They wanted to enforce the law again. On top they said they are gone, you know, that age, and there you are, they are imposing it. So it's a contradiction, and you have to be careful. In fact, this thing will become clear if you think of the Gentile. A Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die, because their laws or their way of life was written over their hearts, not in the law books. So in Jesus, you know, we don't need law books. We should go by hearts as the Samaritan did go. So law had its own time when the old cloth became full of holes, useless, then the law lost its importance. Corrupt law for the corrupt people. And now we need honest people to work for the royal kingdom of God. So we worship God in truth and in spirit, no more hypocrite like these dog-colored people. They are working for Mammon, and they tell the other people with the dog collar that they are men of God. And they will ask them, confess sin, this and that. What sins have to do with God? Nothing. That was with the old letter. Transgression against the letter is sin. Now is the time of Spirit, Holy Spirit. Transgression against the Holy Spirit is blasphemy. So when we have gospel, we expose blasphemers. We expose blasphemers. You know, this is wrong what they are doing. Hypocrite, politician, and all those are exposed. And so should be these dog-colored priests. So there you are. And hope we are picking up slowly.